Hello everyone and welcome back to the introduction to the UE4 editor video series. In this video we're going to talk about placing objects in your level. There are a couple different ways we can go about doing this. We're going to cover each of them. The best way to illustrate this though is to start with a brand new level. We've been using the blank project that had starter content enabled and had some props placed in our scene for us, but we're going to start from a brand new level. So I'm going to go up to new, our file, and click new level. And then click default. So I have a brand new level with only a player start in it and a floor. If I were to play in there now, you would see it's completely empty and very uninteresting. So we can go ahead and add some things to make it a little bit more interesting. So I'm gonna press escape to exit out. Now the first way that we can go about placing objects in your level is through the modes panel and place mode, which is the default editor mode inside Unreal Engine 4. Again, there are several different other modes that you could be in, but for this video, since we're talking about placing stuff, we're going to stay in the place mode. And the way you can do that is very straightforward, is just by dragging and dropping things into the viewport. So we have this cube here. I could drag and drop that in. And I could drag a cone in and place it on top of my cube or next to my cube in the floor like that, because that's lovely. Or I could drag in lights or a trigger to turn off and on the light if I wanted. But that's the basic concept. There are several different categories. Again, basic has the most commonly used things, like static mesh is using for blocking out your levels with cubes or spheres or cylinders, etc. Lights for adding lights, different kinds of lights. Again, you just drag and drop them in. Any kind of visual effects, BSP brushes to help create your levels as well. Volumes, these are things like post-processing effects, different kinds of blocking volumes to keep players inside your levels, things like that. There's quite a great deal of them. You can scroll through them and see them all. We're not going to place everything, but those are just some of the different volumes. Then there's all classes, which is basically everything that can be placed in there. So you can scroll through this and see the different types of things that you can place, but essentially anything in here can be dragged and dropped into your level. The other method of placing objects in your level is through the content browser, which is down at the bottom of the editor. We included starter content in this project, so I'm just going to illustrate that. If I went into the starter content props folder, you can see we have a bunch of different static meshes that we can drag and drop in the same way that we did in the modes panel. So I can just drag in a chair or drag in a door right there in front of the chair and a light fixture. All these kinds of things I can just drag and drop into the level. Now, when you drag and drop something into the viewport, by default, it should show the move tool. We're not going to get too much into moving objects in this video because we're going to cover that in another video more extensively. If you don't see it, you can press the W key or click the move or select and translate objects button up here at the top. Again, we'll talk about moving stuff in a different video, as this video is primarily just placing things in the scene. Now, aside from using the modes panel or the content browser, inside your level viewport, you can also right click and it brings up a context menu where you can place things as well. So you can place, you can place a ceiling lamp. It just allows you to quickly place multiple instances of things. If you want to have a bunch of ceiling lamps, for example, in your level, if you had multiple chairs that you wanted to add, etc. That's how you would go about doing that, just by right clicking and choosing place actor. Now you can see it expands. You could also select different items, some of the items that are found in the modes panel as well, like lights and cameras and player starts and things, just from right clicking as well. And you also have your recently placed too as well, so you could toggle between different things that you want to place. The concept of placing things is pretty straightforward. There was one other thing that I wanted to cover. We already talked about the all classes and how you can place different things from the modes panel that don't fall into these categories. If you go up to window and it's under developer tools, it's a little bit more of an advanced method of placing things. There's an option called class viewer. So if I open that up it's going to show me a list of all the different classes that are available on my project. And anything that's blue in here can be dragged and dropped into our scene. So we have some blueprints that were included as part of starter content. For example, fire, I can drag and drop that in. Now I have fire in my level, smoke, etc. All of the things in blue can be dragged from the class viewer into your level as well. Now you probably won't have to do this too much. Most of the stuff will be done through the content browser or the modes panel, but it's a nifty option that's there if you'd like to use it. And there you have it. That's pretty much the core concept of placing things. It's pretty straightforward. That's going to wrap things up for this video. In the next video, we will talk about moving objects. I hope you guys tune in.